It appears we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim. Yet again.
From behind! Incoming! The Alpha!
End this story.
Mm-hmm.
Sigil arrows won't work on this. Sigil arrows won't work on this.
Stories are of no comfort. Take solace in knowing you did what you thought was best for your son's safety. Even these creatures know. There is little choice for a parent. You are not alone.
I'm not, am I? And now neither are they.
Misty. It's beautiful.
Thank you, Kratos. This land sings once more. We've done good here.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens?
A statue of my brother. How quaint.
That's odd. The runes are dark.
What purpose does all this serve, other than a testament to my brother's vanity?
Difficult to say without an inscription, but it looks like the elves built this place together, light and dark, which means this would have been their first act of cooperation in generations. A far cry from lasting peace, but perhaps it served as a monument, one that symbolizes the potential for peace.
Statue may have survived Freya's absence, but a truce clearly did not. Monuments are useless to those who ignore their message.
He didn't create a truce through diplomacy alone. His godhood, his very presence is what healed this land and allowed peace to take root. But once he left, he had to have known what would happen.
Well, he had good reason to leave. Some jackass convinced his sister to marry a madman.
You said monuments are useless. Why restore this one?
It was hidden for some time. Perhaps now it can serve as a reminder.
Aye. Nothing reminds people of their history like chiseled, well-lit marble.
Crystals contain their own light.
You're right. Normally, we'd have to provide our own. Perhaps slotting a crystal on the opposite side could shed some light on this mystery.
Ring of crystal shards glow.
Looks like we can read the inscription now as well.
in honor of the Enlightened One. May his gift of light shine eternal. Ah, gift of light.
Light from the crystals. It is in the sand now.
Would you look at that? Freyr's gift endures after all. Or should I say, his presence?
You are not funny.
Was fragile. Surely a bit of extra light in the desert isn't enough to make it last.
Before I met Fae, I could not imagine a life of peace. After her death, in our travels to Jotunheim, I found peace on my own. It remains my responsibility to make it last.
Perhaps the elves will find peace again one day, even without Freyr's guidance.
His presence continues to guide them. Whether they realize it or not.
Bring these two animals back to Vanaheim, or Midgard even. Speki and Svanna could use a company. We have kennels.
It would not go well for them. Once a predator becomes accustomed to a land, it is cruel to move them.
I suppose you're right. Just seems lonely out here.
It is peaceful. They have each other. It is enough.
Dawnbloom. You have an interest in botanicals now?
Another raven sent to the Tree of the Dead. Perhaps we should check up on it, hmm? Another sleeping troll, courtesy of the dwarves.
You know, Freyr loved to breed Gulan pups in Vanaheim. I wonder if these two are the descendants of the Gulan he brought here long ago.
That explains how they got to the desert. Another gift for the Dark Elves.
Come on.
I wonder, how'd these two pups end up yoked to the sled?
Ever try flying in a sandstorm? I imagine Freyr showed the Dark Elves that Gulong could be trained to pull a plow. They must have found new uses for them once the sandstorm arrived. I imagine they're now bred to aid in traveling the surface.
making up that story about your brother? You mentioned a giant had come to Vanaheim to teach you of the Bifrost.
Yes, Gerd. Freyr became immediately infatuated with her. He always yearned to wander, and along came someone who could truly show him home. So, wander they did, exploring the world tree from root to branch. But one day, it came time for Gerd to wander away. Freyr was heartbroken, and resolved himself to perform some great feat to win her back. He set his aim on the grandest of gestures. He intended to be the first to find the elusive source of Bifrost Light. And he succeeded, although... quite by accident. Freyr believed he navigated best while fortified by a potent blend of Vanir herbs. When he wandered, he wandered. And he managed to wander from the World Tree directly into the Lake of Souls.
Another time. We must focus.
What is that?
A phantom! Rogue magic! Aim for the rooting core!
Bloody hell! Look at that way!
Attack!